What's up, Tim Sykes, Millionaire Mentor and Trader here, showing you different patterns, showing you my trades to help you understand how fast trading can be, especially when you're dip buying morning panics or trying to capture morning spikes. Never forget, 90% plus of traders lose. It's due to lack of preparation. It's due to lack of execution. It's due to having the wrong broker. It's due to having the wrong strategy. It's due to having the wrong mindset. I mean, literally, I'm inundated with messages from people who have no idea how to trade, or they don't know how to maximize the trading opportunities. That's a mistake. That's why I make videos like this. So I have a clip from this morning where I actually had a loss on ABML. I was trying to dip buy the stock. It was down from basically 5 to 4, which normally, I mean, a 20% dip in a few minutes, that usually creates a good dip buying opportunity. But ABML also is up from 1 last week. So it's one of the biggest percent winners in the entire market. So even though I'm dip buying it and looking for the bounce, I'm gonna be very, very cautious, because you never know if, you know, a dollar a share dip could turn into a $2 or even a $3 a share dip. And I don't wanna get caught in anything like that. That's how, you know, morning panics are created, by people who are unprepared and they're trying to sell all the way down. So I dip bought it, but in this clip, you'll actually see me lose roughly $1,000. Which, you know, I mean, I'm not proud of it, I'm not excited about it, but sometimes that happens. It's kind of like a paper cut. I was up around 8,000 on the day. This knocked me down to 7,000. By the end of the day, I made some other trades and finished up around 12,000. But you'll see me trade very, very cautiously on ABML, because I give it a chance, but when it does not bottom properly, I'm like, forget this. And I actually played it overly safe, because it actually did bounce a little bit more over the next hour, over the next 2 or 3 hours, actually. Coulda, woulda, shoulda gotten out for a profit, but I'm not so interested in, you know, a small profit. If it does not do what I want, I get out. That's how cowardly I am, okay? And I think that's very good. This is how I've succeeded and lasted in this niche that really destroys most people who try, because they're not cautious enough. They're not scared enough. If you follow me on Twitter, which I encourage you to do, I'll post some links to my social media below this video. You'll see me get in fights with people because they're like, you don't need to trade scared. You play too cautiously. And I say, no, 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 no. I've been doing this 20 plus years. You can never be too safe. You can never be too cautious. I don't mind if I exit a stock for a small loss, protecting my earlier gains, even if the stock comes back, because I like trading scared. Trading scared makes trading not so scary, especially with penny stocks. You're welcome to ignore my rules. You can trade as aggressive as you want. Just don't say I didn't warn you, because I did. And I like playing overly safe, and you'll see me play overly safe in ABML coming up. Also, leave a comment below saying I will be safe if you promise to trade scared, if you promise to follow my rule number one and cut losses quickly. That's how you protect yourself in an industry where most people fail.
So just waiting on the big panics. This is really trading. It's like just like a waiting game. GameStop is up to 115. Nice short squeeze above 87 to 115 in the past 15 minutes.
There's no telling where this one can go now.
It's beautiful.
I love it. ABML broke that low.
Saw that 425, very nice. OZSC back to 14 now, 40% bounce off the lows. ABML finally panicking. Down from 490 to 4. That's actually a solid panic. So Jack was on the right track. I hope he got back in.
Yeah, I actually took a little bit short of that. I have a 470 average.
Who has shares? What is that, Cobra?
Trade zero.
Okay.
I hate him.
Yeah.
But Cobra was such a lengthy application process, and I couldn't find a printer.
ABML
ENZC is going up too. Forgot about that one.
Oh, yeah.
But I want ABML to crack four.
Come on. Yeah, me there
too.
We go.
Let's get it.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Crack it. Thank you.
Ugh, still holding the four area.
Yeah, it's frustrating.
Got some at 398, 15,000. Still hanging on. Got the panic on ABML, so I got the dip. Tougher with these higher price plays to make a solid percentage. It's gonna have to bounce 40 cents a share just to do 10.
Right. Yeah.
But I'll take it, you know. We got the right pattern, that's all that matters.
Why do you want to take 14?
You want the break of those key levels. It's the maximum stop losses. Holding right now at 405. I'm up 7 cents, but barely. I might have to take a loss on this last chunk. Because it's those dip buyers like me who create the fucking panics. Come on.
There we go.
Come on. No. Ay, ay, ay. I got in too early. Opening myself up to risks. Cutting losses. Nice little stutter step, faking me out. Got a little too greedy. Got it at 390. Well, I got out at the sim price. I literally thought I was gonna get out at 390, and I got 390 just in a very different way than I thought.
Yep. Oh, that's funny.
I'll take it, and now it's bouncing. So maybe I just played too safe, but I will always protect when a stock is overextended, like it is.
Yeah, I got out of my short at 370s. Just this, I mean, it's still strong on the day, and we're in just such a weird market.
Lost roughly 1,000, and now it's bouncing some more.
But this is what we've been doing, these stutter steps. With a double bottom, and it wipes out the weaklings like me.